Today, we are going to talk about aeronautics and movies. Well, actually, we're gonna talk about one movie. And this movie is Flight. Flight is a movie directed by Robert Zemeckis, who is well known for Forrest Gump or the Back to the Future trilogy, and starring Denzel Washington, whom you may have seen in movies like Training Day or Malcolm X. It tells the story of Whip Whitaker, an airline pilot. During one of his flights, a problem occurs and the plane starts to descend steeply. As you could imagine, the passengers are not pleased with this. The controls are not working and the situation seems catastrophic. But then, Whip has one brilliant idea. He proceeds to put the plane on its back, which results in getting back to an horizontal position. Whip feels quite badass, but the ungrateful passengers are still like... After a few minutes of inverted flight, Whip puts back the plane in a normal position and manages to crash land in a field. Luckily, most people on board survive. But it appears that Whip is an alcoholic and was drunk while piloting, so there's an investigation and a trial. You can watch the movie. What interests us is this question. Is it really possible for a plane to fly on its back? And the answer to this question is...
Yes, well actually, but only for aerobatic planes. But the kind of plane that interests us is more a big airliner. So, is it possible for an airline pilot to do like Whip in this film? To answer this question, we are gonna need a little bit of physics. Here is a funnel. Let's imagine we make air pass through it. The flow of air has to remain constant. For example, if we make 1 cube meter per second go in the funnel, there has to be the same flow in the other hand. And to keep this flow constant, the air has to accelerate in the narrow part of the tunnel. The consequence will be a decrease of pressure. The air will be less pressurized in the second part than in the first. This phenomenon is called the Venturi effect, and this is what makes planes fly. Here is the profile of a wing. We can see that the path above the wing, the extrados, is longer than the path under the wing, the intrados. But exactly like for the funnel, the flow of air has to remain constant. The air is quicker above the wing. And there is a difference of pressure which generates a lift force. If the plane is speed enough, this force will counterbalance the weight, and the plane will fly.
But let's get back to the movie Flight. What would happen if the plane was flying on its back and if the wing was upside down, just like they do in the film? Well, exactly the same phenomenon, but in reverse. The pressure would be greater above the wing than under. And instead of counterbalancing the weight, the lift force would be added to it. The final result being, as you could imagine, a violent crash. And this is why you unfortunately can't fly on the back with an airline plane, even though it would be quite badass. It is possible for aerobatic planes to do so thanks to symmetrical wings, the lift force being created by inclining the wing. But those wings are much too fragile for big planes like airliners.
But let's admit that it will be physically possible for an airline plane to turn on its back. Pilots can do what they want in their planes, and usually the roll angle is limited by the systems. Here is the example of an A380. In the green zone, the pilot is free to control his plane. He can go in the orange zone, but as soon as he releases the controls, the plane will automatically get back to a position of 33 degrees. And no matter what the pilot do, he will never be able to have more than 67 degrees of roll angle. So, even with a completely drunk pilot, there are still safety nets which prevent the pilot to do some huge mistakes. Isn't that reassuring? Try as you might.